Hey, how are you? In this video, I will be using a form request to add complex conditional validation rules or to update or change the validation rules depending on the submitted form fields. First, I will start with some bootstrapping, so if you want to jump straight to the solution, please check the video description for the correct time. Right here, I have brand new installation of Laravel, and behind the scenes, I just use the artisan command to scaffold the authentication. And I did this because I want to take advantage of the controllers and the forms inside the template to submit some form data. So we're going to use this home controller for our demo purposes. And instead of loading the home template, I want to display the register template. And I want to disable the authentication middleware because we won't be logging in. So when I go to a browser and I open this home route, we get this registration form. Now when I open the template, first I want to do some cleaning up. So we don't need any emails and we don't need a password. So I will remove these fields and I will duplicate the name fields a couple of times. The scenario that we will be imagining is that this is an e-commerce application, and when you register, you have the option to register as an affiliate. And when you register as an affiliate, the bank account field becomes required. Otherwise, if you register as a customer, you don't have to fill the bank account field. So I will go to the first field that we duplicated, and I'm going to rename this to "Are you an affiliate?" And all of the mentions of name I'm going to rename to "Are you affiliate" with underscores. And of course, this one needs to remain as the name attribute. So next, the other field, this will be our bank account. And again, all dimensions, I will call them bank account with underscore, and again fix the name attribute. So now when I go to the browser and refresh, we get name, are you an affiliate, and bank account. Now this form should not submit to the register route because we want it to go to our controller. So I will call this route home.store, and inside the controller I will make this method called store, and here for now we will just die with all good. Now in order for this to work, I need to make the route. I called it home.store, and we want this to submit to the store method, and this needs to be post. Now when I refresh, I'm going to fill this and submit the form, we get all good as expected. Now let's get started on the form request. I'm going to open the console and create a new request class. So PHP artisan make request, and we are going to call this home request. Now inside the controller, we want this method to be validated with this home request. And here we want to be authorized all times, and for the rules we're going to start with name, which is going to be required. Next, are you affiliate, and this is going to be required as well. So now when I refresh the page, I will enter a value for name, and when I submit, we only get an error for our are you an affiliate field because we left it empty. Now what we want to do is add validation for our bank account field, and this will depend on the value that we submit on our are you an affiliate field. So what we want to do is have the bank account required, but only when you are an affiliate. So to do this, we need to get the value of are you an affiliate. So first I'm going to make a variable called rules, and I'm going to set it to the rules array, and I'm going to return the rules at the end of the method as expected. And now for the part where we get the affiliate value, we can call this get, which will get any value from the request, and we want to get are you affiliate, and we want to check this against any value or any condition that you might think of. In this case, I'm going to compare this to I am. So if our field are you an affiliate has a value of I am, then we will assume that this person wants to be an affiliate. And now to check this variable, so inside this bracket, the condition will let us know that this person wants to be an affiliate. So I need to add to the rules our bank account validation. Okay, let's give it a try. First I will refresh. I have a name. Are you an affiliate? I am not. And I submit, we're all good. I have a name. Are you an affiliate? I am. And I will skip the bank account. I will submit the form, and you see our validation works as expected. Now if I provide a value for the bank account and submit the form, you see that we're all good. This is one way to solve this problem and add or update any of the validation rules on some type of condition. The next way I'm going to show you is with a method called with validator, and this method has a parameter validator. And if you haven't seen this inside the documentation, this method is called from the parent, the form request. So if you open the form request and we search with validator, you can see that this method is called when the validator instance is created. So right here we have access to the validator, and we will be adding a sometimes rule. This rule is a dynamic and depends on a boolean value which is returned from a callback. So sometimes you might want to run this validation and sometimes you might not. Now we want to validate bank account field. Our rules will be only required. And this is our callback which will return the boolean if we want to validate or not. And this will have a parameter of input. Now like I said, we need to return a boolean here. So it's pretty much the same like we did a minute ago. If the person is an affiliate, we want to validate the bank account, and I have to spell bank correctly. And this variable input gives us the same functionality that we used before. And here we can get the value of are you affiliate. Okay, now let's give it a try. First I have a name, are you an affiliate? I am not. I submit, it's all good. Now, are you an affiliate? I am. I don't have a bank account, and this tells me that the bank account is required. Now I will add a bank account, submit again, and we're all good. So this is all for this video. I hope that this was useful for you, and have in mind that this way you can also get binded route parameters and use their properties for adding more complex validation rules. So if this is something you want to see in another video, please drop a comment below and let me know. Also, if you have any questions, please leave a comment and I'll try to answer them as soon as I can. Thank you for watching.